In this video, we learn about what is embedded systems, characteristics, IPR, and examples, followed by videos on design challenges faced, components used in making embedded systems, embedded system hardware, memory, peripherals, embedded software development tools, and embedded system development lifecycle. Computing systems are everywhere. What comes in our mind is desktop. PCs, laptops, mainframes, servers. But there's another type of computing system which is far more commonly found in automotive, consumer electronics, medical, telecommunication, military, aerospace, industrial control, and so on. These computing systems are called embedded systems. An embedded system is a computer system with a dedicated function within a large mechanical or electrical systems, often with real-time computing constraint. There are billions of units produced yearly compared to millions of desktop units, perhaps 50 per household and per automobile. Typically, an embedded system, when compared with other devices, they consume low power, small in size, rugged in operating range, and cheaper in cost. For example, a digital multimeter, as shown, is a typical embedded system. This embedded system has two inputs, the mode selection dial on the front and the red-black test probes. The output is a liquid crystal display LCD showing measured parameters. The large black chip inside the box is a microcontroller. The software that defines its very specific purpose is programmed into the ROM, read-only memory, of the microcontroller. There is not much inside the box other than the microcontroller, a fuse, a rotary dial to select the mode, a few interfacing register, and a battery. Schematic diagram for embedded system. A schematic diagram helps to visualize how multiple objects are going to be connected. This can involve connecting wires to a battery, lights, circuit breakers, pipes to valves, air conditioning units, etc. We can read following from the schematic diagram shown. Inputs: mode selection dial, red-black test probes, sensors like ultrasonic sensors, humidity, PIR. The output display device are liquid crystal display LCD showing measured parameters, flashing of LED indicating status of measured values, actuators, solenoid mini valves for gas control, and motors. One chip solution having CPU, central processing unit, RAM, random access memory, EEPROM, PROM, ROM, IO, input output, serial and parallel, timers, interrupt controllers, all in a chip called microcontroller. The software that defines its very specific purpose is programmed into the ROM, read-only memory, of the microcontroller. Digital consumer market. Embedded systems are in every intelligent devices that are used in our daily lives. In digital consumer markets, embedded systems range from portable devices such as digital watch, set-top box, high-definition TV, PDAs, multifunctional product or printer or peripherals, MFP, which incorporates the functionality of multiple devices in one functions like print, scan, fax, and photocopy. Some even include simple document storage and retrieval with the basic authentication function and so on, making it as a higher end MFP. And MP3 players to large stationary installations like traffic lights, factory controllers, and largely complex system like hybrid vehicles, MRIs, and avionics. Robotics are built on the foundation of embedded systems. Azimo, advanced step in innovative mobility.
is a humanoid robot designed and developed by Honda, a multifunctional mobile assistant with aspirations of helping those who lack full mobility. Ability to recognize moving objects, postures, gestures, its surrounding environment, sound and face, which enables it to interact with humans. The robot can detect the movement of multiple objects by using visual information captured by two cameras, eyes, in its head and also determine distance and direction. These are sensors that assist in autonomous navigation. The laser sensors is used to detect ground surface. The infrared sensors with automatic shutter adjustment based on brightness is used to detect pairs of floor markings to confirm the navigable path of the planned map. The preloaded map and the detection of floor markings help the robot to precisely identify its present location and continuously adjust its position. There are front and rear ultrasonic sensors to sense the obstacles. Aibo. Robot dog Aibo does just about everything a real dog does. It fetches, follows and wags its tail. Also carry and play your MP3. It has sensors, touch, camera, rangefinder, microphone, acceleration, angular velocity, a speaker and actuators, leg, neck, mouth, tail. As the Aibo series developed, more sensors and actuators were added. Wi-Fi was available as an add-on for some second generation Aibos. RoboCleaner, fully automatic RoboCleaner, a cleaning robot. Cleaning couldn't be easier. Simply plug in the charger station, switch on, set the cleaning time and leave the rest to the RoboCleaner. It cleans fully automatically and negotiates obstacles such as cables and wires. Four optical sensors enable RoboCleaner to identify stairs reliably with a dirt recognition sensor, sweeps and vacuums all on its own automatically. It is guided by an infrared beam, makes it to return to the base station automatically. Contact sensor reliably guide the RoboCleaner around all obstacles. Its flexibly mounted wheels enable it to travel easily over different types of floor covering and small ridges. Embedded systems in aerospace and defense.
Embedded systems in defense and aerospace have to be extremely rugged and highly reliable in extreme environmental conditions. Defense experts are reaching out to the industries for ways to develop handheld bomb detection devices that will detect and image the internal components of concealed explosives to protect military personnel and equipment. Experts are looking for information on systems or technology that will enable them to carry the device in their backpack or cargo pockets to capture the images in real time, as well as provide direct digital radiography visuals. Communications are vital in supporting aerospace and defense command and control systems. Situational awareness is vital for good decision making, and having the most accurate information is fundamental to the success of the mission. Effective communications require collecting data from a range of sources, many of which rely on high-speed data networks. For this reason, many have adopted 4G LTE long-term evolution to support next-generation battlefield communications. Mars Pathfinder, a robotic spacecraft that landed on Mars in 1997. The Mars Pathfinder conducted series of investigations on the Martian soil using scientific instruments. It sent photographs and analyzed data on the chemical properties of the locations to Earth. The computer of the Pathfinder lander was a IBM RISC 6000 single chip CPU with 128 MB of RAM and 6 MB of E2 PROM and its operating system was VxWorks. A concurrent software bug called priority inversion jeopardized the mission, since logging and debugging functionality was enabled in the flight software. A software solution was patched to enable priority inheritance.
Almost every car that rolls off the production line these days makes use of embedded technology. Most of the embedded systems in automobiles are rugged in nature, networked to act as sub-modules in a large system, and compact size enable them to fit easily under the hood of a car. In automotive systems, more and more equipments are being changed from the mechanical systems to electronic systems. Embedded system is the heart of a vehicle electronic system because of its versatility and flexibility. Today, a typical vehicle contains around 25 to 35 microcontrollers, and some luxury vehicles contains approximately 60 to 70 microcontrollers per vehicle. Today, a typical automobile on the road has computers-controlled electronic systems, and the most commonly used embedded systems in a vehicle include GPS, night vision and lane warning, adaptive cruise control and collision warning, tire pressure monitoring, instrument clusters, parking reverse assistant, head-up display, multimedia system, telemetrics, internet access, and many more. Few more examples of embedded system.
Embedded systems are commonly found in consumer, cooking, industrial, automotive, medical, commercial, and military applications. Telecommunication systems employ numerous embedded systems for telephone switches, for the network to cell phones at the end user. Computer networking uses dedicated routers and network bridge to route data. Consumer electronics include PDAs, MP3 players, mobile phones, video game console, digital camera, DVD players, GPS receivers, point of sales, POS, and printers. Household appliances such as microwave ovens, washing machines, and dishwashers include embedded systems to provide flexibility, efficiency, and features.
IPR, intellectual property rights.
Embedded system developers want to protect their intellectual property, IP, for financial, competitive, and legal reasons. Aside from protecting their own IP, developers may be obligated to secure libraries or rights managed content obtained from an outside vendor. Failing to protect the IP of outside vendors may expose developers to legal and financial risks. Techniques for protecting IP in embedded system vary greatly. These techniques rely on software, hardware, or a combination of both to prevent reverse engineering and IP theft. A hardware design may be created only off-the-shelf parts, so it would be difficult to protect the IPR. Competitors can get the board, trace the printed circuit, and if they know what the components are, can reproduce the board. Some companies remove the markings from chips and add dummy chips to make them anonymous. Chip level protection. Many processors contain on-chip memory including SRAM, ROM or flash, which cannot be easily read from outside the device. On-chip memory can be utilized to hold sensitive code and data that must be protected from access by unauthorized parties. Access to on-chip memory can be restricted from host devices as well as from emulator and test equipments via JTAG, Joint Test Action Group. Test ports by blowing on chip fuse to disable JTAG or by providing no connection to JTAG signals from package to board. However, removing access to JTAG test ports removes capability of failure analysis and system debug. Note, unless you are making a production product and wanted to keep your code a secret, only then use such techniques. Else, you would destroy the only interface to the circuit. IP protection in this new generation of embedded processors can be enabled by providing a privileged mode of operation in which only trusted code is allowed to exist. For an application to establish trust and to reach the privileged mode of operation, standard-based cryptography algorithms can be used to implement digital signature authentication. Only after successful verification of an application's digital signature does the processor grant the application the right to execute in privileged mode.
Classification of embedded systems. Embedded systems are designed to do some specific tasks rather than be a general purpose computer for multiple tasks. Some also have real-time performance constraints that must be met for reasons such as safety and usability. Others may have low or no performance requirements, allowing the system hardware to be simplified to reduce cost. Embedded systems are not always standalone devices. Many embedded systems consist of small computerized parts within a large device that serves a more general purpose. Let's compare between general purpose computers versus embedded device.
The amount of processing power necessary to get the job done. A common way to compare processing power is the MIPS, millions of instructions per second, or FLOPS, floating point operations per second. If two processors have ratings of 25 MIPS and 40 MIPS, the latter is said to be the more powerful of the two. A general purpose single core microprocessors with 2.5 GHz processor has 10 gigaflops, whereas for embedded systems need 1 to 10 MIPS or max 100 MIPS for mission critical system. Another important feature of the processor needs to be considered is the register width, which typically ranges from 8 to 16 bits. Today's general purpose computers use 32 and 64 bit processors exclusively, but embedded systems are still commonly built with older and less costly 8, 16 and some with 32 bit processor. Next, an embedded system will have very few resources when compared to a full blown computing system like desktop. The memory capacity and processing power in an embedded system is limited. It is more challenging to develop an embedded system when compared to developing an application for a desktop system, since we are developing a program for a very rigid environment. Some embedded systems run a scaled down version of operating system called RTOS, real-time operating system. Next, embedded system range from no UI user interface at all in a system, example LED decorative serial lights, to complex graphical user interface that resemble modern computer desktop operating systems, example smartphone using a graphical screen with touch sensing. Next, usually embedded systems are high resource constrained compared to the desktop PC. Embedded systems typically have limited memory, small or no hard drives, and in some cases
with no external network connectivity. Next, general purpose computer usually serves a number of purposes: checking email, surfing the internet, listening to the music, word processing, etc. Whereas embedded systems usually have single task or a very small number of related tasks that they are programmed to perform. Next, embedded system typically operates 24/7. Example, modems, security system, pacemaker, refrigerators, and so on. Next, embedded systems are mass produced, 10 lakh units, and dedicated to specific tasks. Design engineers can optimize it to reduce the size and cost of the product and increase the reliability and performance. The trade-off between production cost and development cost is affected most by the number of units expected to be produced and sold. For example, it is usually undesirable to develop your own custom hardware components for a low volume product. Next, embedded computers rarely will have a generic interface. Even if embedded systems have a keypad and an LCD display, they are rarely capable of using many different types of input and output. For example, for simple security alarm system, the I/O capability required will be an LCD for status display and keypad for entering a password.
Embedded system characteristics, user point of view. Embedded computers typically have tight constraints on both functionality and implementation. Single function with tight constraints. An embedded system is a combination of hardware and software, either fixed in capability or programmable, that is specifically designed for a particular function. They must guarantee real-time operation, reactive to external events, conform to size and weight limits, budget, power and cooling consumption, satisfy safety and reliability requirements, time to market, and meet tight cost targets. Small size, low weight. Many embedded computers are physically located within some large systems. Therefore, their form factor may be dictated by aesthetics. Example, in transportation, weight may be critical for fuel economy. Cost sensitivity. Even though embedded computers have stringent requirements, cost almost always an issue. Cost is not just digital electronics or software alone, but overall system cost. For example, in the signal processing system, the cost sensitivity can be estimated at approximately $1,000. Real-time and reactive operation. Real-time systems operation means that the correctness of computation depends on the time at which it is delivered. In many cases, the system design must take into account worst case performance. Reactive computation means that the software executes in response to external events. These events may be periodic, in which case scheduling of events to guarantee performance may be possible. On the other hand, many events may be aperiodic, in which case the maximum event arrival rate must be estimated in order to accommodate worst case situation. Most embedded systems have a significant reactive components. Harsh environment. Many embedded systems do not operate in a controlled environment and get exposed to vibration, shock, lightning, power supply fluctuations, water, corrosion, fire and general physical abuse. Applications involving combustion in automobile needs accurate thermal modeling. Safe and reliable.
Some systems have obvious risks associated with failure. In mission-critical applications such as aircraft flight control, severe personal injury or equipment damage could result from a failure of the embedded computer. Traditionally, such systems employ multiple redundant computers in order to ensure continued operation even after an equipment failure. In this case, design challenge would be in implementing low-cost reliability with minimal redundancy. Let's see embedded systems characteristics from developer's viewpoint. Concurrent development of hardware and software called code design. Variety of microprocessors to consider. ARM, Intel, Atmel, Motorola, Texas Instruments, Zilog, Renesas, and so on. Variety of operating systems to look at. VxWorks, MicroC OS, QNX, Embedded Linux, RT Linux, ECOS, MicroC Linux. Many such real-time operating system. A simple printf statement is perhaps the most flexible and primitive tool. Printing out variable values allows you to discover how your program is operating. Printing out variable values allows you to discover how your program is operating. Unfortunately, printf is quite intrusive and greatly slows execution. Hence, RTOS may not even have any OS services like printf. The program instruction written for embedded systems are referred as firmware and are stored in read-only memory or flash memory chips. They run with limited computer hardware resources, little memory, small. What is real-time system? A real-time computing is a computing where system correctness depends not only on the correctness of the logical result of the computation but also on the result delivery time. Two types of real-time systems, soft and hard. In soft real-time systems, tasks are performed by the system as fast as possible, but the result do not have to finish by specific time. Whereas in hard real-time systems, tasks have to be performed not only correctly but on time. Most real-time systems have combination of soft and hard requirements. Example, aircraft control, ticket reservation system at airport, over temperature monitor in nuclear power station, mobile phone, oven temperature controller, Doppler blood flow monitor, ECG monitor. Example of real-time systems. Airbag. An airbag is a vehicle safety device. During a crash event, the vehicle's crash sensors provide crucial information to the airbag electronic control unit, ECU, like angle and severity of the impact. Depending on the result of these calculations, the airbag ECU crash algorithm determines if the crash event meets the criteria for deployment and based on which triggers various firing circuits to deploy one or more airbag modules is logical result. The airbag must quickly and fully inflate by the time driver or occupants reaches its outer surface. After the onset of the frontal crash, the decision to deploy an airbag is made within 15 to 30 milliseconds, and both the driver and passenger airbags to be fully inflated within approximately 60 to 80 milliseconds after vehicle's contact, called result delivery time. If an airbag deploys too late or too slowly, the risk of occupant injury may increase or even leads to catastrophic. ABS, anti-braking systems, has electronic control unit, wheel speed sensor, and brake hydraulics. The ECU constantly monitors the rotational speed of each wheel. If ABS detects a wheel rotating significantly slower than the other wheel or turning significantly faster than the other wheel, then it may result to wheel lock. Based on the condition, ABS actuates the valves to either reduce or increase hydraulic pressure on the affected wheel. Thus, by either reducing or increasing the braking force on that wheel avoids wheel lock. Hence, safety is achieved. Some ABS apply or release braking pressure 15 times per second. Note: failure is inability to perform according to specifications. In the case of real-time systems, the failed specification may be lack of correctness or the failure to produce the response by the required time. How products are developed without OS, kernel? Small systems of low complexity are generally designed as foreground, background, or super loops. An application consists of an infinite loop that call modules or functions to perform the desired operations, that is background. Interrupt service routine, ISR, handle asynchronous events, that is foreground. Foreground is also called interrupt level. Background is called task level. Critical operations must be performed by the ISR to ensure that they are dealt with a timely fashion. Because of this, ISRs have a tendency to take longer than they should. Applications like microwave ovens, telephones, toys, and so on, which are based on microcontroller, are designed as foreground background systems. Also, in microcontroller based applications, it might be better from a power consumption point of view to halt the processor and perform all of the processing in ISR. Foreground, background. Main function is the entry point of your program called as background. ISR function called as foreground. When entered main function, the first step is to perform initialization of the modules, which will be used by the applications like ADC, DAC, PLL, UART, IO ports, and so on. Once done, you enter infinite loop and make calls to the various functions like read analog inputs, digital inputs, keyboard scanning, and so on. Critical operations must be performed by the ISR to ensure that they are dealt in the timely fashion. Because of this, ISR have a tendency to take longer execution time than they should. Also, the information for a background module that ISR makes available is not processed until the background module gets its turn to execute. This is called task level response. The worst case task level response time depends on how long the background takes to execute. Since the execution time of the typical code is not constant, the time for successive pass through a portion of the loop is non-deterministic. Advantage of foreground and background. This approach suits for low-cost embedded application. Memory requirements depends only on your application. 1 KB for small application to 16 to 32 MB for machine. The worst case task level response time depends on how long the background loop takes to execute. Since the execution time of the typical code is not constant, due to execution of conditional statements like if, for, while, the time for successive pass through a portion of the loop is non-deterministic. All tasks have the same priority. Code executes in sequence, that is, if any important event occurs, it's handled at same priority as everything else. Hence, you may need to execute same code often to avoid missing of an event. You have to implement all services like time delays and timeouts, timers, message passing, and resource management. Code is harder to maintain and can become messy.